Have you ever had a moment where you wish you could go back in time and capture something from your screen or from a game when you forgot to hit record in OBS? Elgato's original Game Capture HD software for their capture cards and NVIDIA GeForce Experience can both let you do that, but now OBS can as well. I've previously covered OBS's replay buffer functionality, but it has improved since then, and there's now a better way to go about it, especially for those of us who use the advanced output mode. We'll be covering that in today's tutorial right after this. TubeBuddy is the best tool you can get to manage your YouTube channel. You can update videos in bulk, optimize your SEO, syndicate to social media, back up your metadata, and more, all with a simple browser extension. Head to eposvox.com/TubeBuddy to learn more and download it for free. We're going to make this simple, but this tutorial will assume that you already have existing recording settings set up and are in the advanced output mode in your output settings on OBS Studio. If you're already lost or confused or don't have recording settings set up yet, check out the playlist link to my OBS masterclass, which will better get you started on the right path. The replay buffer has moved and now works in the advanced output mode, which means that you can use your high-quality recording configuration to save clips after the fact, instead of just constantly recording entire sessions at a time. Using the replay buffer is my favorite way to do game captures. Open your settings in OBS Studio, click Output. If you're in advanced output mode, click over to the replay buffer tab. If you use simple output mode, refer to my previous tutorial linked in the video description. This is for advanced output mode. Check Enable Replay Buffer. Now you have two numbers to play with to determine how the replay buffer will work. In most cases, you can just change the maximum replay time in seconds to however long you want, and the second number will just adjust for you. Obviously, there's 60 seconds and 1 minute, so you can work out the math from there. For most users, 1 to 2 minutes is probably best for this, but you can go higher. You can see here mine is set to an absurd 3,500 seconds, which works out to a little more than 58 minutes, but that's not how long it actually saves for me. The replay buffer works by recording your stream to RAM as if it was recording to disk, and then just queuing up enough to save that set amount of time to disk when you tell it to. OBS Studio can use a maximum of 8 gigabytes of RAM for the replay buffer, which is what I have allocated here. You see, I record using the CQP rate control method in the NVENC encoder, set to a lossless recording, so it doesn't have a manual bitrate to determine how much RAM it needs. This 8 gigabytes of RAM allocation usually equates to about a minute or a minute and a half of recording games, which is fine for me. Obviously, don't set more memory allocation than you have available. I'd say 50% or less of your total RAM should be used here. I have 64 gigabytes of RAM in my system, so I'm safe. But again, for most people using CBR or VBR recording, you don't even have to touch the maximum memory field. It can usually calculate that for you. Hit Apply, but don't close the settings. Now you need to go down to Hotkeys and assign a hotkey for Save Replay, as there is no dedicated button for it. You can also add a hotkey for starting and stopping the replay buffer in general, but I usually just use the UI button for that. I have my Save Replay hotkey set to Alt F3. I don't actually hit that key combination myself. I simply map Alt F3 to a button on one of my Elgato Stream Decks and have it save in one button press. But you can set it to whatever combination you want, just something that you won't accidentally hit when you're normally playing. Hit Apply and you're good to go. Now this will save you if you forget to hit start recording, but only if you remember to hit start replay buffer, so it's not perfect. You have to turn this on and off every time you use OBS, or it doesn't work, so keep that in mind. Also, if you hit the hotkey to save replay buffer multiple times in a row, it will record mostly duplicate data, only adding the new data since your last press to each clip. This works a bit differently than something like NVIDIA Shadowplay, where it only saves video after your last save. But multiple audio tracks do work with replay buffer now, so that is a huge plus. Honestly, my big complaint is that there is no indicator that the replay buffer has been saved. With the Stream Deck keys being a little soft, sometimes I'm not certain if I hit it all the time and wind up saving it twice just to be sure, which is a minor annoyance. But now you're off to the replay races. Like I said, this is the way that I record most of my clips for my capture card reviews and things like that, because it's super convenient and far more convenient than recording long gaming sessions and having to scrub through them to find clips worth saving or find the interesting bits. If you like this tutorial, hit the like button and subscribe for more tech education. Consider contributing on Patreon to keep tech education free and going and yada yada. And I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and I will see you next time.